are having this function. Now in this function, there are some locations where the function is assuming a value 1. Here in these locations, the function is assuming a value 1. And there are some locations where the function is assuming a value 0. Okay. Now these locations where the function is assuming a value 1, I can represent these locations like this also. For example, here this is 0, 0, 1. For A it is 0, for B it is 0, for C it is 1. So I can write it as A complement, B complement, C. You can write it as A, B complement, C. You can write it as A, B, C complement. And you can write it as A, B and C. So for the locations where the function is assuming a value 1, I can write these locations as A complement, B complement, C plus A, B complement, C plus A, B, C complement plus A, B, C. Now in this complete expression, this is a min term. 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 And this is a min term. All these locations where the function is assuming a value 1 represents a min term. Now by looking at this, you can clearly see for this particular combination, for any particular combination, this particular combination will only get a value 1 for a one single combination of A, B and C. For example, if we pass 0, 0, 1, 0 in A, 0 in B and 1 in C, then only this combination is going to give you a value 1. Otherwise, this combination will give you a value 0. In the same way, for this particular combination will give you a value 1 for exactly one possible combination of A, B and C. Now this combination will give you a value 1 for exactly one particular combination of A, B and C. For this combination, it will give you a value 1 for exactly one combination of value for A, B and C. So if I write what is a min term, a min term is a product term where the variables can be either in complemented or uncomplemented form. So what is a min term? A min term is a product term. Is a product term where the variables can be, either in complemented, or uncomplemented form. For example, here in this expression, this complete is a min term. In this expression, this complete min term, A and B are in complemented form and C is uncomplemented form. Here, A, B and C, all these three are in uncomplemented form. Here, A and B are in uncomplemented form and C is in complemented form. So, min term is a product term because for these three variables, we have product. So a min term is a product term where the I variables are either in complemented or uncomplemented form. And the second point is a min term assumes a value 0. So assumes a value 1 for exactly one combination of variables. For exactly one combination of values of variables. For example, this expression is going to give you 1 only if you pass 0, 0, 1. If you pass anything other than 0, 0, 1, then this expression, this min term is not going to give you a value which is 1. For this min term is only going to give you a value 1 if you pass 1, 1 and 1. 1 for A, 1 for B and 1 for C. If you pass anything other than 1, 1, 1, this expression will not going to give you a value which is 1. Okay, now for example, assume this. If we have a function like this, let us assume a function is A plus BC. A function is A plus BC. And assume this is a function F2. So this function F2 can also be denoted like this. This is F2. Here it is A plus BC, that means this function is going to give you true if either A is true or B and C both are true. So this function F2 can also be represented like this. Either A is true at these locations 1, 1, 1, 1 or B and C both are true at this location, otherwise it is going to give you value 0. This function can be represented like this, right? Now this function, so you can write this complete function like this also. You can also write it like this. So this location is noting A complement BC. It is A complement BC. This location is noting A B complement C complement plus A B complement C complement plus this location is noting A B complement C A B complement C plus this location is noting A B C complement A B C complement plus this location noting A, B and C. It is noting A, B and C. This is the function F2. So we can represent a function F2 like this, and we can also represent a function F2 like this. Here in this function, this complete is a min term and this is a min term because itself is a product term, because instead of B and C, we are taking a value which is 1. Right? And here in this expression, this is a min term. This is a min term, these and these, all these are min terms, right? But the difference here is this function F2 will be representing a canonical form, or you can say canonical collection of min terms, canonical collection of min terms, canonical collection of min terms, and it is also called as canonical sum of products, canonical sum of products, or you can say canonical SOP. This expression can only be called as sum of products, or you can say SOP. So what is the difference between the canonical SOP and SOP is, in case of canonical SOP, all the locations where we are having the value 1, we are going to represent all these locations with all the three variables. Here we have three variables, for in every min term we should have the three variables. In case of canonical SOP, if we have a three variable function, then every min term should have three variables. If you have a four variable function, then every min term should have a four variable. But here in this function F2, A is not having three variables, as well as BC is not also not having three variables. So this function F2 is only sum of product. So why do we call it sum of product? Because you can see, this is a product term. This is a product term. A min term is also called as product term. This is a product term. And we are adding, or we are doing sum of these product term. Therefore, it is called as sum of product form. Therefore, it is called as sum of product form. So a min term is assuming a value 1. A min term is assuming a value 1 for exactly one combination of variables. Now, if in a function you represent all the min terms in such a way that all the variables which are present inside the function, all these variables are in those min terms, then it is called as canonical min terms, or you can say canonical sum of product, or this kind of product term is called as sum of product form. Okay, so let me show you. Let me give you a definition of this. So if I call the sum of all so if I say the sum of all min terms of function f for which f assumes 1 is called a canonical product of sum or disjunctive normal form, or you can say, if I say the sum of all min terms of f for which f assumes a true value, f assumes a true value. True value means we are talking about the value which is 1, for which f assumes a true value is called as canonical sum of product. Canonical sum of product. So this is representing a canonical sum of product. Okay. Now the locations where the function is assuming a value 0, that gives a canonical product of sum. For example, here in this case, you can see this location and this location. So in all these three locations, the function is assuming a value 0. So for the first location can be denoted by A plus B plus C, because whenever we are getting 0, I am writing it as uncomplemented form. And here we are getting A plus B plus C complement, and this expression is getting A plus b complement plus c. So what is the difference between a min term? So these are actually called as max term. These are called as max term or product of sums. How will we write product of sum forms? So these are sum terms. So I can write it like this: a plus b plus c dot a plus b plus c complement dot a plus b complement plus c. So these are the product term. These are the product terms. These are the product terms. So what is the difference between a sum term and a product term? These product term assumes a value 0 for exactly one combination of variables, and these sum terms assumes a value 1 for exactly one combination of variables. Okay, so for example, here if you pass 0 0 0, then only the value of these sum terms will be 0. Right, so here we are in case of min terms, we are looking at a value 1. In case of max terms, we are looking at a value 0. So wherever we are getting zeros, we can represent these locations by product terms like this: a plus b plus c. And if we pass anything other than 0, 0, 0, if you pass anything other than 0, 0, 0, then these values will be 1. So we are interested in case of product terms, we are interested. So in case of max terms, we discuss about the value 0. Okay, let me elaborate it again. In this function, in the case of this function, you can see this function is assuming a value 0 at this location as well as at these locations. So I can represent this value as a plus b plus c. I can represent this value as a plus b plus c complement. I can represent this value as a plus b complement plus c, and I can represent this value as a plus b plus c complement. So why I'm representing these values like this is, this is a max term, and this max term will assume a value 0 only if we pass 0 0 0. That means it will be having a value 0 only if we pass 0 in a, 0 in b, as well as 0 in C. Here it will assume a value 0 only if we pass 0, 0, 1. Right, so then only this value will be 0. Right, so next term is the product of sum. Product of sum forms. Product of sum. Okay, so the product of sum, I can write it like this: A plus B plus C dot A plus B plus c complement dot a plus b complement plus c dot a plus b plus c complement. Right, so this is the product of sum. That means we are doing product of sum expressions. We are doing product of sum expressions. Again, we have two types of product of sum. Number one is a simple product of sum force, that is POS. Second one is a canonical collection of product of sum forms, or you can say canonical product of sum forms. So what is a canonical product of sum? For example, in case of product of sum, if we have a function which is representing a, b, c, then we can represent a function like this: a plus b dot a plus b complement plus c. Right, so here in this case, in every product term, in this product term, we don't have the variable c. In case of canonical product of sum, like for example, this is a canonical product of sum. If the function is of three variables, now in case of canonical product of sum, these terms, every product of sum term, or you can say every max term, should assume a value 0 for exactly one combination of variable, and all these max terms, on every max term, all the three variables should be there. For example, here in the function, we have three variables. Therefore, all the three variables should be there in the max terms. All the three variables should be there in the max term. Again, all the three variables should be there in the max term. In case of product of sum terms, it is not necessary that every product of sum term is canonical. For example, here, because here we have a plus b, but we don't have the variable c, therefore, this expression is just representing a product of sum term, but this is not representing a canonical product of sum term. Okay, so there's a difference between canonical and simple, like product of sum and canonical product of sum, in the same way, sum of product and canonical sum of product. Okay, so let us look at more definitions after this. Now let us look at these four questions. They are saying write the SOP and POS expression for this. And where we have pi, pi means we are representing that we have a product of sum, and summation means we are representing we have sum of product. Okay, so assume we have this A, B, C and D. So all these are having 0 to and everything between 0 to 7. Therefore, there must be three variable functions. And assuming those three variables are A, B and C. So we have A, B and C. What are the combinations of A, B and C? They can be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1, 1. Okay, so this is representing 0, this is representing 1, this is representing 2, it is 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. These are the combinations of A, B and C. Now the first one, assume this is A, so I am representing by FA. So in the first one, we have pi. Pi means we have product of sum of, that means it is giving the locations where the function is assuming a value 0. So where are the locations where the function is assuming a value 0? It is assuming a value 0 at 0, 2, 3, 5. And all the other locations the function is assuming a value 1. Okay. In the second case, we have written a summation term. That means we are giving a SOP expression. We are giving an SOP expression. In the second case, the function is assuming a value 1 at 0, 2, 4 and 6. So 0, 2, 4 and 6, and all the other locations the function is assuming a value 0. In the third case, the function is assuming a value 0 at 1, 3 and 7. At 1, 3 and 7, and all the other case the function is assuming a value 1. Okay. In the fourth case, it is summation. So function is taking a value 0, 1 at 0, 1, 3, 5 and 7. So 0, 1, 3, 5 and 7, and all the other locations the function is having a value 0. Okay. So the first expression, this first expression can be represented like this, because here it is pi, so it will be like this, where the function is assuming a value 0. The function is assuming a value 0 at this location, it can be represented by A plus B plus C complement. The next is A plus B complement plus C. So A plus B complement plus C. Third one is A plus B complement plus C complement. So it is A plus B complement plus C complement. And here it is A complement plus B plus C complement. A complement plus B plus C complement. So these are the four terms. Now the second case, the function f of b, in the second case the it is giving summation. Summation means the locations where the function is assuming a value 1. So what are the locations? Here it is A complement B complement C complement plus A complement B C complement plus A B complement C complement A B complement C complement plus A B C. So it is A B C. In the third case, here we have pi. Pi means the POS form, or you can say product of sum form. So these locations where the function is assuming a value 0. So it is assuming a value 0 at A plus B plus C complement dot. Next is A plus B complement plus C complement. A plus B complement plus C complement dot. A complement plus B complement plus C complement. A complement plus B complement plus C complement. Okay, in the fourth case, the locations where the function is assuming a value 1, because it is summation. So it is A complement B complement C complement plus A complement B complement C plus A complement B C plus A complement B C plus A B complement C plus ABC plus ABC. Okay, so these are the SOP and POS forms. So let me check it again. So it is 1, 2, 3, 5. So there should be 4 terms, 1, 2, 3 and 5. So it is representing 1, it is representing 2, it is representing 3, it is representing 5. That's okay. Second is 0, 2, 4, 6, 0, 2, 0, this is representing 2, this is representing 4, this is representing 7, this one is wrong, 0, 2, 4, 6, no? So it is 0, 2, 4, 6, 0, 2, 4, 6, so it should be ABC complement. Okay, so third one is 1, 3, 7, so this is representing 1, this is representing 3, this is representing 7, that's fine. Last one is 0, 1, 3, 5, 7. So 0, this is representing 0, this is 1, this is 3, this is 5, and this is 7. That's okay. So this is how we can write the SOP and POS form. All these forms, whatever I've written here, is they are canonical forms. Okay. So now let us look at some of the functional properties after this. Let us try to answer this question. With n variables, how many Boolean functions are possible? How many Boolean functions are possible? For example, we have to, let us start with two variables. For example, we have two variables a and b. Then how many functions are possible over this? The possible values of a and b can be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So we can have the following functions. We can have function f1, which is 0, 0, 0, 0. We can have a function f2, which is 0, 0, 0, 1. We can have a function f3, which is 0, 0, 1, 0. We can have a function f4, which is 0, 0, 1, 1. A function f5, which is 0, 1, 0, 0. A function f6, which is 0, 1, 0, 1. A function f7, which is 0, 1, 1, 0. A function f8, which is 0, 1, 1, 1. A function f9, which is 1, 0, 0, 0. F10, which is 1001, F11, which is 1010, F12, which is 1011, F13, which is 1100, F14, which is 1101, F15, which is 1110, and F16, which is 1111. So with the help of two variables, if we have two variables a and b, then there are 16 functions which are possible. These are 16 functions which are possible, right? Okay, and there are four combination of these variables. Okay, now if you have a variable 1, if you have only one variable, that is a, then the values can be 0 and 1. Then how many functions are possible? The first function can be 0, 0. Second function can be 0, 1. Third function can be 1, 0. And fourth function can be 1, 1. So these are four different functions which are possible. So here for a single variable, there is only one combination. So two combinations. And with these two combinations, four different switching functions are possible. Four different functions are possible. Okay, so if the value of n, if this is n is representing number of variables, n is representing number of variables, if the value of n is 1, that means if the number of variables are 1, then number of combinations possible and number of functions which are possible. Number of functions. If there is only one variable, then there are two combinations are possible and there are four switching functions are possible. If the number of variables are two, then there are four combinations of these variables are possible. There are 16 switching functions are possible. In the same way, if the number of variables are 3, then there are 8 combinations which are possible. And with these 8, there are 256 switching functions are possible. Now the question is, if you have n variables, then how many combinations are possible and how many switching functions are possible? You can clearly see there are 2 raised to power n combinations are possible, and there are 2 raised to power n switching functions are possible. 2 raised to power n switching functions are possible, because for each of these 4 combinations, we have 2 raised to power 4, that is 16 switching functions are possible. Okay, now look at a few more things related to this. Let us look at the previous question in a different manner. So if we have, for example, n variables, this is a variable v1, variable v2, variable v3, up to so on, variable vn. If there are n variables, for these n variables, 2 raised to power n different combinations are possible. Why? Because this variable can assume 2 values, either it can assume 0 or it can assume 1. This can assume 2 values, 0 or 1. It can assume 2 values, 0 or 1. It can assume 2 values, 0 or 1. For every variable, we have 2 choices. We have 2 choices. We have 2 choices. We have 2 choices. So how many choices we have? 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. That is equal to 2 raised to power n choices, or you can say 2 raised to power n different combinations. In the same way, if we look at how many functions are possible, then for all these different combinations, for every combination of function, we can assume 2 values, either 0 or 1. For every combination, we have 2 values, For 2 raised to power n combination, we have 2 values. So how many switching functions are possible? 2 raised to power n switching functions are possible. We have already discussed in the previous video. Okay, now let me modify the previous question. If I say, let us make it easier in the first case, and then we'll make it a little bit harder. Okay, assume if the question is like this: if we have 3 variables, and in a function, there are exactly 3 minterms. Then how many such functions are possible?
That means इस तरह के कितने functions यहाँ पर बनेंगे?
Okay, so for this, let us assume we have 3 variables. We have function with 3 variables. Assume this is a function with 3 variables A, B, and C. The combination can be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1, 1. Okay, and now he is saying we have exactly 3 minterms. That means in a function we have exactly 3 ones. Those ones can be anywhere. Those ones can be here also, right? Those ones can be like this also, right? We have 3 minterms, and these ones can be placed anywhere in any combination in those 8 locations, right? For this question, we can clearly see this question is of choices. That means if we have 8 locations and we want to make 3 locations as one, then how many such different positions can be available, or how many such different combinations can be available? So this question can also be written like this. For this, if we have total 8 choices for 3 variable function, we have total 8 choices. Out of these 8 choices, we want to make 3 choices as well. So it is 8C3, that is 8C3 combinations are possible for these ones, right? So if you write this particular question in terms of variables, you can see if we have n variables, and there are exactly k minterms, then how many such functions are possible? Okay, so the answer to that question will be 2 raised to power n combinations for those variables, ck. 2 raised to power n ck, that means for these n variables, there are 2 raised to power n different combinations are possible. For example, for these 3 variables, 2 raised to power 3n, that means 8 different functions are possible. Out of these 8 different functions, we have to make 3 functions as 1, and all the locations should be 0. So if you write exactly, that means 2s power n c k. But if the question is, instead of exactly, we say we have at most, or we can also have at least. We can also have at least. What do you mean by at most? The question is, if we have n variables and there are at most k minterms in the function, at most, that means max to max, there are k minterms. So minterms can be 0, minterms can be 1, minterms can be 2, but at maximum there will be k minterms, right? So in that case, how many functions are possible? There will be 2 raised to power n c0 plus 2 raised to power n c1 plus 2 raised to power n c2 plus up to so on 2 raised to power n ck. 2 raised to power n ck. And when the question is about at least, when the question is at least, that means there are at least k minterms, then it will be how many functions are possible? 2 raised to power n ck plus 2 raised to power n ck plus 1 plus 2 raised to power n ck plus 2 plus up to so on 2 raised to power n cn. 2 raised to power n c, 2 raised to power n. 2 raised to power n c, 2 raised to power n. Okay, so this is for at least, this is for at most, and this is for n variables. Okay, so you can answer this question like this. I hope this is visible. If it is not visible, then I can write it upwards, but